sharing on some of the qualities and what God desires from us leaders, it will be our responsibility to pray, oh God, make me to be a leader that you desire me to be. Praise the Lord. Because unless we portray leadership in what we are doing, or we show leadership and we'll be sharing broadly, we will not achieve so much. We will be magnifying some things, and there are things that God wants to do, but we may not be able to do because we have delayed. Let's look at Jesus himself as the great leader. In Mark chapter 3, we look at Jesus as the best example of the leaders that he's looking for. Then we will connect that with Judges chapter 5, verse 6 to 9. Mark chapter 3, and we are reading from verse 13. Mark chapter 3 from verse 13, we'll be going around this scripture with a few others. The Bible says, and he went up on the hillside and called to him those whom he wanted and chose. And they came to him, and he appointed 12 to continue to be with him, and that he might send them out to preach as apostles or special messengers, and to have authority and power to heal the sick and to drive out demons. And the names of those leaders are from verse 16. So Jesus is building his team. Jesus has a vision to conquer the world. Jesus has a vision to fulfill the agenda of the Father. Jesus has come to do the will of the Father. Remember, I told the Pharisees that what I am doing is what the Father is doing. So Jesus, he comes in as a leader who wants to fulfill the agenda of the Father. Praise the Lord. And we need to understand that in every area of our life, there must be leadership potential. There must be leadership potential. And that's why, as we are going to pray this weekend, as we are praying this month, or whatever time we are praying, one of the areas that I want us to pray in the church of Jesus is that, oh God, give us potential leaders. Now, Jesus had many disciples, but he had a group of people that he wanted. Them that he knew they are going to fulfill his purpose and his agenda. And now the Bible says, Jesus went up to the mountain. And when he was up to the mountain, he called those that he wanted. Praise the Lord. There is a group of people that Jesus wanted. There is a group of leaders that Jesus wanted. He just didn't want any leader. But the Bible says he went up to the mountain and called unto him them that he wanted. Amen. For this ministry to grow, for your life to grow, for your business and whatever you're praying for this week to grow, there must be a leadership that you want. Amen. Not all people are potential leaders. All can be leaders, but they cannot be potential leaders. That's why I was saying, when you go to the market, even a madman is a leader. Amen. So, Jesus calls them that he wanted, and that they might be with him. So, we want to combine that with Judges chapter 5. Let's combine with Judges chapter 5, because I want to talk about, we want to begin with the spirit of responsibility. The spirit of responsibility. So, Judges chapter 5, the story of a judge called Deborah. So, Deborah is one of the judges in Israel. And Deborah becomes becomes a judge at a time that Israel wanted a savior. At a time that Israel wanted somebody to take over responsibility. Deborah becomes a judge in Israel when no one wants to take the first step and lead Israel. Deborah is taking up leadership when men are hiding. Men were supposed to take over responsibility. They were hiding. They were not being seen. So Deborah comes in as a judge. She comes in to take responsibility because she understood the timing for the deliverance of children of Israel. She understood the timing. So a leader must understand the timing. And that's why as leaders, we need to tell God, oh God, show me the timing that we are in. What am I supposed to be doing? Amen. That's what the Bible says. And when you look at verse 6 of Judges, verse 6, chapter 5, verse 6, Judges chapter 5, Judges chapter 5, verse 6, the Bible says, after the days of Shamgar, son of Amar, after the days of Jael, meaning here, Ehud, the caravan ceased. Trans elders walked through byways. The villages were occupied. And the ruler ceased in Israel until you arose, you Deborah, a mother of Israel. Now look at what the Bible says. After the days of Shamgar, son of Anan, after the days of Jael was one of the ladies, meaning here Ehud, the caravans ceased. Travelers walked through byways. The villages were unoccupied. The rulers ceased in Israel until you arose, you Deborah. What a special. Now, this is the situation that Israel was in. That people were just by the wayside, which means nobody was taking responsibility. And we are living at a time with the church brethren when there must be a leadership that is ready to take the responsibility. There is so much that God has in store for us. Amen. There is so much that God has in store for the church. When people are walking by the wayside, when leadership has ceased in the church, the Bible says caravans ceased, travelers walked through the byways, the villages were unoccupied, the rulers ceased in Israel. Amen. This is a critical time when we needed a responsible leader. Elders are not there. Villagers, anybody could do what they want to do. And the Bible says, until you arose, oh Deborah. So Deborah decided to arise and take responsibility to bring deliverance. And there was a culture in Israel where women were never appreciated. This is the first woman we see in the Bible who is a judge. Because the culture of the Jews never allowed a woman. It's just like the African culture. So Deborah decided to take responsibility. One of the son. One of the prayers I want us to pray is that, oh God, among as many prayer items we have, God, give us responsible leaders. And if you are a leader, you can pray and tell God, God, make me a responsible leader. Amen. And we will look at the spirit of a responsible leader, how it works. So God gives deliverance to two women, Jael and Deborah, because they decided to take responsibility. You are either an asset or a liability. That's why Jesus was specific with the leaders he wanted. What a special. He just did not take anybody. He had a leadership line that he wanted. And that's what the Bible says. And they read the names. He's Peter, James, John, as they go down. And Jesus knew, with these leaders, I will fulfill what I want to fulfill. So we want to pray that God give us asset leaders in church. Amen. We just don't want to have leaders. Why are we talking about leadership today in this prayer week? Because all of us are leaders in one area or another. And we'll be looking at many areas in business, at home, where you are working, you are a leader. It's not only in church. But as a ministry, the church needs asset leaders. What is responsibility in my context of this picture on teaching? Number one, responsibility to me is being an answer of what you are looking for. Responsibility is being an answer of what you are looking for. We go back to Jesus in Mark chapter 3. And he chose the 12. Sindio. And he gave them power to do what? Why did he bring them on board? He appointed them. And he called them to do what? What was the assignment? What was Jesus looking for?
Preach.
Heal the sick. Cast out devils. So Jesus has had a specific agenda for choosing these leaders. That's why I say responsibility is being an answer of what you're looking for. So Jesus is looking at healing the sick, casting out devils, preaching the gospel. What are you looking for as a leader? That's an answer. In the department where you have been placed, what are you looking for? What do you want to achieve? In the department where you are the head, what is your goal? What is your agenda? We'll be looking at goals later on. But Jesus, as a responsible leader, he wanted to have answers. And the call was preach the gospel, heal the sick, cast out devils. You can never be a leader if you're not looking for answers. You can never be a leader if you're not looking for solutions. You can never be a leader if you are not looking for solutions. If you are not being an answer. So, responsibility here means being an answer to what you are looking for. That's why Deborah became an answer to Israel. Because Israel was looking for a deliverer. Israel was looking for a deliverer. And Deborah, as a responsible leader, brings in the answer. As a leader in this church, as a leader where you are, there must be something you are looking for. There must be an answer. What a special. Number two, responsibility here means being an answer of what people are looking for. Being an answer of what people are looking for. again as our model leader. He brings in a team. And Jesus knows people are looking for salvation. People are looking for healing. People are looking for deliverance. So he chooses leaders, responsible leaders, who are an answer of what people are looking for. Amen. As a ministry, for example, what are we looking for? What are we looking for as a ministry? As a church in Maseno, what are we looking for? What is our focus? And that's why we bring in leaders who will become an answer of what we are looking for. The reason why we are in prayer this week, there must be something we are looking for. Is it the way? No. There is something we need. There is something we want. There is something that people of Maseno are looking for. There is something your family members are looking for. So a responsible leader is someone who is an answer to what people are looking for. That's why Jesus, when he came, he became an answer. When Jesus came, he became a curse that we may do what? We may be blessed. He became poor that we may be rich. He took up our shame that we may receive our dignity. So Jesus as a leader, he brings an answer to what people are looking for. As leaders in this church, we must always have that in mind. There is something we are looking for. There is a level we are looking for. And that's what we need to pray for. So responsibility or a responsible leader. Number three. Number three, a responsible leader like Deborah and Child is somebody who you hold yourself responsible for the needed change. You are the pioneer. You are the initiator of the needed change. You hold yourself. Haungojei wengine wakuanzishie. You hold yourself responsible as the initiator of change. That's why Jael, again the Bible says, when people were by the bayside, the villages were unoccupied. Nobody was ready to take responsibility. Deborah arose to bring change. Amen? To cover more. So, a responsible leader is one who takes the forefront. You are the one who understands the need of change. Amen? You initiate. You don't wait for people to push you. You initiate change. We will see an opportunity and you seize the opportunity. That's why the Bible says, in the fullness of time, God sent what? Sent Jesus Christ. In the fullness of time. So when God knew there was needed for change, he brought in Jesus. And Jesus, when he knew there must be a change of order, a change of worship from the Pharisees and the Sadducees, he brought in a new crop of leadership to bring change. Jesus initiated it. That's why one day he stands in the temple in Luke chapter 4, verse 31. And after he called the scroll and he has read through the scroll and he read what was being read every Sabbath. And the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, for he has anointed me. See you? And he closed the scroll. And the Bible says the eyes of everybody was fixed at him. And they say, what is in this man's words?
Jesus initiated church
as a leader.
A leader must be a change initiator. There are things that must just change in the church. For us to experience revival, for us to experience the fullness of the blessings of God, there are some orders that must change. And God is waiting for a leadership that is ready to initiate the change. I don't know if you are part of it, my brother, my sister. You are responsible. The department where you are in, you are responsible. Hallelujah. That's why you are a leader in your sphere where you are. So you hold yourself responsible. Mimi ndio na answer. Sita ngoja mtu. Sita sukuma kwenda kuomba. I will, as a leader, I'm appreciating it. I'm doing it. And that's why Jesus wanted leaders around him who will do exactly that. Who will initiate? That's why one day they went and preached in a city and they came back with a good report. Wakambia Jesus, even the demons obeyed us. They initiated change in that city. Peter, James, John, and the disciples. They brought change and they said, even the demons have obeyed us. Jesus said, no, don't rejoice because of that. That is the responsibility I've given you. But rather rejoice that your names are written in the book of life. Leaders who will bring change are responsible leaders. But today is sad to say, my brother, my sister, that we are entering into a season where we don't have a responsible group of leaders who are willing to say, we will take over and do what God wants us to do. So you must be responsible to bring in the needed change. For change to come, we must have a people with another spirit. For change to come, we must have a people with another spirit of responsibility. And I will show that in the Bible. For change to come, we must have a people with another spirit of responsibility. Lazima tuwe na watu tofauti. Now let's look at the crop of leaders of Jesus. Now Jesus, by the time he goes to the Father, he left 120 disciples. That's why when the Spirit of God came, the 120 were upstairs. Sawa? But when Jesus was doing ministry, the Bible says he sent out the 72. But when Jesus wanted to have his leadership discussions, he had in the 12. Sawa? And when Jesus wanted to have the executive meeting, he had how many? 3. Those were the executive leaders. Peter, John, and James. That's why when he has secrets, he has something to share that is a secret, he picks the 3. He goes to the mountain of transfiguration. Moses appears. Elijah appears. And the Bible says, when they were going up, he left the 9 down and picked how many? Because he knew these 3 have a spirit that is different from the 9. They are able to keep secrets. And that's why he tells them, please, when Peter says, oh, it's good that you have been here, let's build us 3 tents. Adam, I decided to rule the city. One will live with Moses, one will live with Elijah, one will live with Jesus. Let the 9 remain down there. Jesus said, no, Peter, you don't know what you're saying. But at the end, he told them, what you see and heard, don't tell anybody. until after the resurrection. Because they had a spirit of responsibility to keep the secret. And they never told anybody until after the resurrection. Now, when you look at the 12 spies who went to spy the land of Canaan, they were 12. 10 came with an evil report. 2 came with what? A good report. Father's first son. And the Bible says, but Caleb and Joshua had a different spirit. All the 12 were leaders. All the 12 saw the giants. All the 12 walked into the land. All the 12 had the fruit clusters that they came with. But 10 were not responsible leaders. Amen. But two of them, the Bible says, they had a different spirit. They took leadership responsibility. They told Moses, listen, sir, we have also seen the giants. We have seen the land is good. It doesn't matter what we have seen. Yes, the giants are there, but let's walk in and possess the land. Because we are responsible. God has given us a responsibility to conquer the land. Let's move in and take over the land. Those are the leaders we want in church today. Sio viongozi wa kutukuja moyo. Sio kukuambia mwezi. Sio kukuambia unajifanya. Sio kukuambia sisi tunaomba sana. Let's be leaders with a spirit of responsibility. That where others see we cannot go, there must be a people say we will go. Where other leaders are saying we cannot be able, let there be a people with a spirit of responsibility like Caleb and Joshua who will say, no matter the challenge, we are possessing the land. Those are the leaders who are praying for, my brother. Well, as your son. But today we have leaders who are not responsible. Well, as your son. Number four, then we'll have some prayer. We'll continue with this. Number four, the spirit of leadership. Number four, behave as if you are the only person available that God will require to use. A responsible leader is the one who behaves as if he or she is the only person available that God will require to use. The only person, hakuna mwingine. Which means this is a leader who is not looking at other leaders. He is behaving like I am the only one. That's why one day, Caleb, when he was so old, 85 years old, he comes back to Moses, to Joshua and Moses, and tells them, listen to me. I was 40 years when God spoke to me about this mountain. Amen. I remember what the servant of God, Moses, said. So he told Joshua, I was 40 years, now I am 85. But give me this mountain. I am the only person who can conquer this mountain. Now, it was the mountain of giants. At 40 years, when they were passing through the land, Caleb saw the mountain of the Anakims, the mountain of the giants, and he told Moses, I am the only person who will conquer these people. Amen. Moses died, but Caleb remembered the words. So when he said, the father says, I know the spirit that I have is like I am the only person who can conquer this mountain. So give me that mountain. available. And I'm using the word available. You are the only leader available that God requires to use. What is killing the church in the area of leadership is we are waiting for who will do than I do. Nani afanye ndio nifanye. Nani aanze ndio nianze. Ni nani atakaye? It's like wale ambao umefuga kondoo. Unaweza fungua nini nyuma boma la kondoo. Na kondoo wataki kwenda. Wanasukumana tu kwa mlango wanasukuma. Yaani wanangojea ni nani wa kwanza pale magari? Ataenda ndio watoke. Sasa wote wanasukuma. Na mlango gate imeshafunguliwa. But they are still waiting. Who is the responsible? Akitoka, ndio anatoka wanaenda. But a responsible leader who has a spirit of responsibility is one who knows I'm the only available leader. Wanasikia? That God depends on me. And that's why I love Philip. You remember Philip in the Bible? Philip, after he was anointed, the Bible says, when the persecutions broke out in Jerusalem, Philip went to Samaria. And remember, Philip is not among the 12, but he's a leader. He is not among the apostles, but Philip was a leader. He knew Samaria must be conquered. And he said, I am the only available leader to change Samaria. So he goes to Samaria, preaches the gospel, and the whole city turns upside down. Then Philip now calls for Peter to come and establish. Philip did not say, let me wait for Peter, James, and John to go first. He went and initiated, and then he brought it upon. A leader is someone who says, sita ngojea, ndio wengine wafanye. Sita ngojea, watangaze maombi, ndio tuombe. Sita ngojea, twende Bible study, ndio tuende. You behave as if you are the only one that God is requiring. And lastly, as a leader who has a spiritual responsibility is one who does not accept excuses. In the state he is, does not accept excuses for change, for the situation we are in, but is available and is flexible. Is available and is flexible. Does not accept excuses. In the situation he is in, or where he is, but he takes responsibility by being available. Being available. Now let's go to the leadership of Jesus. Who are they? Who was Peter? A fisherman. Sawa-sawa? Who was James? A fisherman. Who was John? A fisherman. Who was Matthew? A tax collector. They had things they were doing. What a special. But when one day Jesus finds Matthew, and by this time Peter, James, and John, they are fishing. And then Jesus says, leave these things, I want to make you fishers of men. Then he tells Jesus, Jesus, now you must understand. That's why we never imagine that Jesus. Yes, we knew. The Bible says, they didn't even make Peter try the excuses as a father God. I can sit to the toilet the whole night. Jesus said, no, me, I just told you, cast your net. So some of us, yes, you may not resign your job. You may not resign, but you can get yourself available. What a special. But the problem we're having with our leaders today
vingine havina maana. But if you want to bring change in the church, people must take responsibility. We must be flexible. That's why I say they must be available for change, and flexibility must be there. Amen. You cannot work from 4 in the morning to 10 in the night. This is your time. Because you are a leader. Yes, you are doing work, you are doing business, but also in the church you are a leader. So your position in church must never have excuses. We must create time. That's what we call flexibility. May God give us grace. The reason why we are not moving so fast, my brother, my sister, we have a problem with the leadership perspective in church. Wakati Mungu anaona nitawachiliaje hii revival, nitawachiliaje baraka. If leaders are not available, I was raised up under Pastor Lai, and I think Pastor Lai, one thing that has made Bishop Lai to be an effective leader in this country is the way he tackles the issue of leadership in his church. That one has made him to be an effective leader, the way he tackles it. And in his church, you can never be a leader if you are not available. You cannot be a leader if you are not flexible. He will tell you, okay, you are going on duty from 6 to 6. What will you be doing from 7 to 5 in the morning? You can create time to pray. That's why in his church, even the same groups that operate on Sunday, whatever on a cast back a Saturday, they have their cycle. Those who go on duty the whole day, they have their prayer hour at 7 or 8 or 9. So that every leader must participate. That's why he has become so effective. Because to him, leadership is important. And that's why even to Jesus, leadership was so important. He needed people so flexible. May God give us grace, brethren. So let's pray that as leaders, God touch our hearts. No excuses. Because we have an agenda. You have an agenda in your family, in your business, in your ministry, in your church. As a leader, there is something wrong. And there must be change. For us to say change, there must be a spirit of responsibility. Deborah brought responsibility. Amen. And there was great victory. Let's stand up and pray. We'll continue tomorrow as God gives us grace. So I want us to pray, and these are the prayer points I want us to pray. I want you to tell God, God, and you are a leader here, tell God, God, I want to be an effective leader. I want to be an efficient leader. I want to be a responsible leader. I know, Lord, I've had many excuses. Maybe I'm not fulfilled what I need to fulfill. Tell Jesus, I want to be a leader that you want me to be. I want to be a solution. I want to be an answer. I want to initiate change. That in this generation, before Jesus comes, before the great breakthrough revival, let Jesus make us the leaders that he needs. And it begins with the responsibility. I want you to cry to God, Father, help me to be a responsible leader. Just as Deborah was, just as Peter, James, and John, and the other disciples were, man, tell Jesus, Jesus, let me be a responsible leader. Give me the spirit of responsibility like Caleb and Joshua, that I'll be able to take the mountains.